I've always been fascinated by amphibians and reptiles. When I was a child, I used to keep them as pets and read books about them. The more I sort of learnt about biology and zoology, the more I became sort of excited about the possibilities of ultimately becoming actually a scientist specializing on amphibians and reptiles. I've been working in Madagascar since 1985. And at that time, Madagascar was just starting to open up again to researchers. There's incredible diversity of species there. And at that time, there wasn't a huge amount known about many species. There were still many, many new species waiting to be discovered. I remember very clearly the very first new species of Brachystia dwarf chameleon that I found in northern Madagascar. With all the literature I had with me at the time, I could see it had very different characteristics. So it was a very exciting moment. The other type of discovery you can have, which is, to my mind, I think just as exciting, is actually rediscovering a species which maybe hasn't been seen for 50 or 100 years. There was a species of gecko in the southwest of the island of Madagascar, which was described about 60 years ago. We went back into the area, we knew approximately where it had come from, but there were no more specimens that had been collected in the intermediate time, and there was a fear that maybe the thing had gone extinct. Through perseverance and effort, we ultimately managed to find the right limestone cliffs where the species occurs and the caves, and ultimately rediscovered the species, which I think is very satisfying, because the fact previously that that species is known maybe by one or just a few specimens, there's no information about the habitat or the behavior, and of course there won't also be genetic data available for that species either. Sometimes you have really unexpected challenges in Madagascar, and we had a situation a few years back during a political crisis where we had to get back to the capital, and that involved us trying to get across this major river, the Betsibuk River, and at that time the bridge was closed. I didn't want to abandon the car or basically wait for, in this case it would have been several months before the bridge would have opened up. We were forced to actually come up with a plan B, which in this case involved us taking a detour down a tiny little dirt track, ultimately ending up in a village about a day later. Through talking to the local people, they managed to assemble a raft for us, which we sort of basically built from three metal canoes, that one of which was actually leaking quite badly, strapped together with just rope and planks. We loaded the vehicle onto this raft, and then had to paddle across this major river in full flood during the middle of the rainy season. So that adventure alone, I remember taking us about 3 days, and certainly there was some considerable risk about if that raft sort of started to fall apart in the middle of the river, then for sure we would have lost the vehicle.